Now let us define the categorical cross entropy. We also say it like softmax loss or softmax activation. Plus a cross entropy loss. You can easily understand the scenario. So the softmax activation is an important part of softmax loss. So first we will go through the brief overview of softmax activation. Suppose we have neural networks which generates some output which may not be the probability score. For example, here output generated is like 3.0. Now let us like 2.0, 0.7. So these are not probabilistic output. So the softmax equation we can define for any given distribution yi e to the power yi divided by sum of j is equal to 1 to, suppose we have n number of elements, e to the yj. So in this case here the softmax calculation will give the output like e to the power 3.0 divided by e to the power 3.0 plus e to the power 2.0 plus e to the power 0.7. Similarly, for this part the output will be e to the power 2.0 plus e to the power 0.7. Here if you calculate, I have just calculated from calculator that its value is around 0.681135 and its value is around 0.250575. and similarly, for if we calculate here, then in the same fashion, like e to the power 0.7 divided by, so it gives the value around 0.06829. Actually we have rounded some values, but without rounding, if you add them you will always get the sum equal to 1. So softmax function converts those values to some probabilistic distribution, and that we can use for multi-class classifier generally. So this is the basic concept behind the softmax activation. Here we can summarize like the softmax activation takes an unnormalized vector and normalize it into the probability. Now we can formally define it like that. Suppose we have CN classes, and for any given feature X we want to estimate the probability of pi being in class I. And now suppose our algorithm just produce real valued score y1, y2, y3, yn, like here that simple neural network that we had computed, just given like that. Then we can use these scores with softmax and define the probabilities like p1, p2, p3, pn, and this is actually the equation of softmax that we describe here like that. So this gives the, suppose this is input x1, so gives the chances x1, x2, x3, gives the chances that what are the probability that this input will belongs to the class 1, belongs to the class 2, sorry, belongs to the class 1, class 2, or class 3. Now come to the discussion of softmax cross entropy. So let us keep two things into the mind. When we computed the cross entropy, we got for distribution y and y dash, we had cross entropy equation as minus yi I is equal to 1 to n log y dash I. So this part we already covered in the computation of cross entropy. Softmax functions we already discussed. Now let us try to understand a simple deep network scenario. Suppose we have a computation of some deep learning architecture, and it gives the, this is just a dummy diagram. I am trying using this to explain the concept and nothing else. So now it generates some score like S1, S2, S3 that we discussed earlier, and after that we generate the softmax score, softmax 1. So now in the to compute the loss in the deep neural network, we generally use this probability values. So because this may be erroneous values, or it may contain some errors, or it may not represent or reflect the proper classes. So through the calculation of loss, we know it. Now we use this. So it is a probability distributions that we get similar to this part. So we replace this softmax part here through our cross entropy equation. So the softmax cross entropy equation will become Li. Li is the target labels vector, probability of target label vector in the classification that we used. And after log, this is the softmax output computed by the deep neural network architecture. So the entire summation will represent the softmax cross entropy value. Now we generally use one hot representation in deep learning. So positive class CP will keep its terms in loss. And there is only one element in the target level vector Li which are non-zero, that is all positive labels. So we can understand this equation like that. Here our softmax equation after this replacement will be like that, minus I is equal to 1 to n Li log e to the power yi divided by j is equal to 1 to n e to the power yj. So we can use this information and take all Li as Lp, and it will be equal to 1. So after discarding all the negative classes Ln equal to zeros, we will have Softmax cross entropy value as minus log yp divided by summation of j is equal to 1 to n, sorry, j is equal to 1 to n for eyj, and we represented it as eyp. Now to compute the loss, the general way to compute the loss is to take the derivation. So here in we will also take its derivation with respect to all positive labels yp, so that we can get the loss for positive classes. So after computation of this derivation, we generally get this value as a loss for positive class. Now let us go through the way to compute this derivation. Actually, if we take the log of any derivation, suppose we say it like log of z, we represent this entire part as z. Then the derivation of log z will give you like z . The second part of this derivation is, now this z contains numerator and denominator. So this z may be equal to, if we take it like gx and hx, then you can get that. And if we represent it as fx is equal to, sorry, gx and hx, then through the simple derivation scheme you already know that it will be equal to derivation of gx into hx minus derivation of hx into gx divided by hx square. So this will be the total formula. So here our gx represents e to the power yp, and hx represents sum of, sorry, here it is equal to 1 to n j equal to 1 to n e to the power yj. So if we take j is equal to p, means all positive classes, then in our case d hx dyp, sorry, yp will be equal to e to the power yp. So in this case our this equation, so in this case we can say it like that, if we discard this part, log part, as we say here, this will I will add at the end of the derivation, so it will be like e to the power yp divided by j is equal to 1 to n e to the power yj dyp, then it will be equivalent to e to the power yp, we can take it like, and we just take this part first, e to the power ip into j is equal to 1 to n e to the power yj minus e to the power this part yp into e to the power yp. Why we take the this part h dash x equal to this divided by into 1 by pi and this part hx square, so hx square and j is equal to 1 to n e yj whole square. So when we try to solve this, we will get the value like we take this part common and one common from here. In that case we will get e to the power yp and j is equal to 1, sorry, j is equal to 1 e to the power yj into, after taking all this common, we will get from here j is equal to 1 to n e to the power yj minus e to the power yp divided by j equal to 1 to n e to the power yj, like that. And if you just go through here, then we said that by taking the derivation of log, it will be equivalent to 1 divided by e to the yp, so j equal to our e to the power yp and j equal to 1 to n e to the power yj. So this part is in the denominator part, so 1 by z. So when we take 1 by z also here, then it will discard this part and finally we will get, if you simplify it, and some minus sign is also here that we didn't take in earlier derivations from here. So after taking this minus sign and taking only this part, then it will be equal to minus of 1 minus e to the power yp divided by j equal to 1 to n e to the power yj, and after taking is will be equal to e to the power yp j equal to 1 to n e to the power yj minus 1. So here you can check that how we can get this derivation. So this is actually the categorical cross entropy loss function. So this is the way we compute the categorical cross entropy loss. However, in Keras or some other libraries, you can directly get it and you may not understand that how internally it works. So this is the actual way that how it is working, and the entire derivations way to get the actual categorical cross entropy loss.